Hello everyone, you are most welcome in AgriGuru.in, a platform where you can enhance and boost up your knowledge with our quality study material in order to crack IBPS AFO mains exam. In this series of quality PDF lectures of IBPS AFO mains exam, we are here with you with a series of video lectures which will be providing you the brief explanation of important topics so that you could be able to clear your mains exam very easily. So now let's start with an important concept, which is tillage. The word tillage, it has been derived from Anglo-Saxon words tillian and tulan, which means to plow and prepare soil for good seedbed preparation to cultivate and raise crops. Tillage is just a mechanical manipulation of soil for obtaining good condition, or you can say ideal condition, for seed germination, seedling establishment and growth of crops. Now the another concepts are dibbling and drilling. Dibbling is nothing, it is putting of seed or any kind of seed materials in a hole or a pit which is made at a predetermined distance and depth. How it is different from drilling process is that drilling is dropping of seeds in furrow of a predetermined dimension at a predetermined distance and a depth. Now the thing which makes it different from dibbling process is that you have to cover the soil and then followed by compacting it. Now it is covering of the soil, or you can say covering with soil followed by compacting is. So by compacting it is the process which completely makes it different from the dibbling process. Now the important fact you have to remember is that the seed drill was invented, which was pulled behind a horse, which was introduced by Jethro Tull. And the Horse Hoeing Husbandry, it is a book which was written by Jethro Tull. Jethro Tull is father of tillage. Now the next concept is blind cultivation. Blind cultivation is nothing, here you cultivate after planting, but the crop is not immersed. So the cultivation after planting and before crop emergence is known as blind cultivation. Now the concept blind hoeing is just the blind cultivation. The hoeing which is done after sowing of sugarcane plant is called as blind hoeing. Here when the crop is not germinated due to some reasons like rainfall just after sowing of the crop and formed hard surface crust. So in order to break that particular crust, or you can say that particular hard layer, the blind hoeing is done. So the concept, or you can say the blind hoeing is done to break the hard surface or the hard crust which has been formed on the surface layer. In order to break this, you used to do blind hoeing. Now the next term is deep tillage. You must have heard about deep summer plowing. It is the same thing. It is nothing, it is just the manipulating the soil at higher depth. So deep plowing turns out large size plots which are baked by the hot sun when it is done in summer season. This process of gradual disintegration of the clods improves the soil structure. So now we will see what are the benefits of deep tillage. Due to deep tillage, the rhizomes and the tubers of perennial weeds, like you can say the world's most problematic weeds like Cynodon Dectranalon and Cypress Rotundus, it dies due to exposure to hot sun. So deep summer plowing kills pests due to exposure of pupa to the hot sun. So a deep tillage of 25 to 30 cm depth, it is very necessary for deep rooted crops like pigeon pea. While you can say moderate deep tillage of 15 to 20 cm is required for maize crop. Deep tillage also improves the soil moisture content. So soil tilt from the depth of 15 to 45 cm generally carried out in the root crops. So next concept is subsoiling. Subsoiling is nothing, it is just the breaking of the hard pan, okay, the hard surface. It is breaking of the hard pan without inversion and with less disturbance of the topsoil. So now we will see that why there is need to break that particular hard pan. Because hard pans may be present in the soil which can restrict the root growth of the crops. For example, cotton roots growth grow to a depth of 2 meter in deep alluvial soil without any pens, I'm saying. When hard pens are present, they grow only up to hard pens, say like 15 to 20 centimeters. So due to the presence of this hard pen, crops are not able to grow properly. So we need to break that particular hard pen which is present on the surface of the soil. So with the help of the subsoiler, we can do the practice of subsoiling, which is breaking of the hard pan without inversion of the soil and with less disturbance of the topmost soil. So now we will see the instrument with the help of which we can break that particular hard pan which is present on the surface of the soil. So chisel plows, which are also used to break hard pans which are present even at a depth of 60 to 70 centimeter. Now after deep tillage, the next concept is shallow tillage. Shallow tillage is done when the soil is tilled up to a depth of 2.5 centimeter to 15 centimeter. Now the fallow tillage and the clean tillage are together known as mulch tillage. The mulch tillage is done in the field where you can see the presence of crop residues. Now the minimum tillage, or you can say the no-till system, it reduces the availability of potassium due to increased compaction, lessened reaction, lower temperature and the position availability, means the availability of this space. Now the one of the important concept is puddling. Puddling is plowing of the land with 5 to 10 cm standing water with an objective to create an impervious layer below the surface of the soil to reduce the deep percolation losses of water and to provide soft seedbed for planting of the rice crop. Now one important fact to remember is that plow, it was invented during 2900 BC. Another fact is that Jethro Tull, he is also known as the father of tillage. Now the tilth is the good physical condition of the soil after tillage in relation to the plant growth. So tilth is nothing, it is the ultimate result of tillage process. So after the mechanically manipulating the soil or the tillage process, the result which we get is that a good tilth, which is the good physical condition for the soil after tillage in relation to the plant growth. So it is helpful for the better growth and germination of the crop. So one of the important objective of the tillage is that it improves the aeration of the soil. So improving aeration is the one of the objective of, we can say, tillage. Due to tillage in the soil, the bulk density of the soil, it decreases. So we have studied about the tilth. What is tilth? It is ultimate result of the tillage process. So good tilth has 0 to 5 mm size of aggregate. Next thing is that iron plow was invented by James Small, and the concept of minimum tillage, it was started in USA. Now one of the important thing to remember is that the optimum range of the soil moisture for effective plowing is 25 to 50% depletion of the available moisture. Now the next thing is that chisel plow, it is used to break the hard pans or the hard surface present at 60 to 70 centimeter depth. Next thing is that in general, a subsoiler works up to a depth of up to 50 centimeter. Now we will see the different tillage implements and their works. Chisel plow, it is used for breaking the hard pan present in the soil. It is subsoil breaking instrument. Next is rotary plow. It cuts and pulverizes the light soil. Next is ridge plow. It is used for earthing up and to form ridges and furrows. Next is basin listener. It is used to prevent runoff and form basins. Next is disc plow. It is a primary tillage implement which is used for deep plowing in grassland fields. Next is tractor drawn cultivator. It is used to destroy weeds and breaking clods. Next is sweep cultivator. It is used in harvesting of groundnut and used in stubble mulching. Next is harrows. It is used for preparation of seed bed and to destroy weeds. Next is planker. It is used in micro leveling. Next is star weeder. It is used in weeding in grasslands and groundnut field. Now you will see that what are the different factors which will decide that which plow you have to select. Now the selection of plows. It totally depends on it depending on the purpose, soil condition and the nature of weed problem. According to these problems or these factors, different plows are used. Now we will see this list of suitable plows for different situation. Now one side you can see the name of plow and other side you can see the situation or a purpose in which we can use these plows. Now next thing is that we will study different kinds of plows one by one. Now first is mold bowl plow, or this is a tractor drawn mold bowl plow which is used in deep plowing and inversion of the soil. Next is mold bowl plow, which is animal drawn. It is used in incorporation of manures, fertilizers and plant residue. Next is disc plow, which is used for cutting of creeping or spreading grass and inversion. Next is country plow, which is used as multi-purpose implement. Now we will study about the different types of tillage. Now first is primary tillage. The tillage operation which constitutes the initial measure soil working operations. It is normally designed to reduce the soil strength, cover plant materials and rearrange aggregates and mainly for seed bed preparation. The main aim of primary plow or the primary tillage is used in breaking or opening and turning of the soil. Now the different primary tillage implements are desi plow, mold bowl plow, ridge plow, disc plow, chisel plows, etc. Now we will see the different objectives of primary tillage implements. And with the help of these primary tillage implements, we do primary tillage, which is used to reduce soil strength, to rearrange aggregates, to cover plant materials and bury weeds, and also to kill insects and pests. Now after primary tillage, we will study about the secondary tillage. Secondary tillage is lighter and finer tillage operations performed in the soil after primary tillage to create proper soil tilth and surface configuration for seedling and planting. And these operations comes under secondary tillage operations. As the secondary tillage operation, it includes lighter and finer tillage operations performed just after the primary tillage operations, so they do not cause much soil inversion and shifting of the soil from one place to another. As secondary tillage causes less soil inversion and shifting of the soil from one place to another, so that's why they consume less power per unit area as compared to primary tillage operations. The tillage operation following primary tillage to create a good seedbed for proper seedling and planting. The secondary tillage implements are like cultivators, harrows, hoe, plankers, rollers, sweeps, clod crushers, levelers, burn formers, etc. Now we will see the main objectives of secondary tillage, which are to break the big clods and make the soil surface uniform and leveled as needed for a seedbed preparation, to destroy grasses and weeds in the field, to cut crop residues and mix them with the topsoil. These were some of the main objectives of the secondary tillage. Now we will study about the different types of tillage systems. Tillage system consists of sequences of operations that manipulate the soil in order to produce a crop. The operations include tilling, planting, fertilization, pesticide application, harvesting, and residue chopping, or we can say shredding. There are basically two types of tillage systems, namely conservation tillage system, which include 30% or more crop residues left after planting and another includes the other tillage systems having less than 30% crop residues left after planting. So first is conservation tillage systems, which include no-till, ridge-till and mulch-till systems, whereas the second one, the other conservation tillage systems, includes reduced tillage systems and conventional tillage systems. So the conservation tillage system here, it includes 30% or more crop residue left after planting. It is any tillage and planting system that covers 30% or more of the soil surface with crop residue after planting to reduce soil erosion by water or by any other means. Next thing is that the conservation tillage system is also known as stubble mulch tillage, eco-fallow or reduced tillage system. Now the conservation tillage systems are further classified as no-till system, ridge-till and mulch-till systems. So the first is no-till system. No-till is defined as a system in which the soil is left undisturbed from harvest to planting except for nutrient injection. Here, the weed is accomplished primarily with herbicide. With the use of herbicide, we will use the or we will control the weeds. Now the second type of conservation tillage system is ridge till system. In ridge till, the soil is also left undisturbed from harvest to planting except for nutrient injection. Here the residue is left on the surface between the ridges. Here we can control the weed, or it is accomplished with the help of use of herbicides and or with the help of cultivation, we can also control the weeds. In ridge till system, we can rebuild the ridges during the cultivation. Now the third type of conservation tillage system is mulch till. Here the soil is disturbed before planting. Here the tillage tools such as chisel, field cultivators, discs, sweeps or blades are used. Here the weed control is accomplished with the help of use of herbicides or by cultivation method. Here the mulch till is a category that includes all conservation tillage practices other than no-till and ridge-till system, which we have studied earlier. Now the second tillage system includes the other tillage system, which has less than 30% crop residues left after planting. These are the tillage systems that leaves less than 30% crop residues after planting and are not classified as conservation tillage system includes in other tillage systems. It basically includes reduced till system and conventional till system. The reduced till system leaves 15 to 30% residue cover after planting. Whereas in case of conventional till system leaves less than 15% of the crop residues cover after planting. Now we will study about the influence of different tillage practices on physical properties of the soil. Tillage system has the considerable influence on the various physical properties like pore space, structure of the soil, bulk density, water content and color of the soil. So that the tillage practices have therefore the greatest effect on seed germination, seedling emergence and stand establishment. Now one by one we will study how these factors affect the seed germination, seedling establishment and the stand of the crop. First is pore space. When a field is plowed, the soil particles are loosed, stacked in a random manner and pore space is increased. So with the help of tillage practices, the pore space is increased. Second is soil structure. Soil with crumbly and granular clods is considered as soil with good structure. When the soil is subjected to tillage, an optimum moisture crumb structure is developed so that losses of soil by erosion is greatly reduced. So with the help of tillage practices, the soil structure is improved. And when the soil is improved, the reduction of the soil, or we can say the loss of the soil by erosion, is greatly reduced. Now the next thing which is influenced by the tillage practice is bulk density. When the soil is loosened, the soil volume increases without any effect on weight. Therefore, bulk density of tilled soil is less than untilled soil. I just want to say that with the help of tillage practice, bulk density of the soil decreases or it reduces. Now next is soil color. Organic matter is the mainly responsible for the dark brown to dark gray color of the soil. So how we can see such kind of coloration of soil due to tillage practices? It is just because tillage increases oxidation and decomposition, resulting in fading of the color. Now next is soil water. Tillage improves soil water in different ways, like the amount of available water depends on soil porosity, soil depth and random roughness. All these characters and properties are increased by tillage practices. Tillage practices also increases rate of infiltration, water holding capacity and hydrolytic conductivity. So we can see that tillage practices have direct influence on the rate of infiltration, water holding capacity and hydraulic conductivity. Next is soil temperature. Tillage creates soil temperature optimum for seed germination and seedling establishment. So these were all about the influence of tillage practices on physical properties of the soil. Now we will study about some of the modern concepts of tillage. First is minimum tillage. Minimum tillage is the minimum soil manipulation necessary to meet tillage requirements. The minimum tillage aimed at reducing tillage to the minimum necessary for ensuring a good seed bed, rapid seed germination, satisfactory stands, and favorable growing conditions. The concept of minimum tillage was started in USA. Now we will see some of the disadvantages of minimum tillage. In minimum tillage, seed germination is lower as compared to other kinds of tillage. In minimum tillage, more nitrogen has to be added as rate of decomposition of organic matter is very slow. Here, the nodulation is affected in some leguminous crops like pea. Here, sowing operations are difficult with ordinary equipments as the mechanical manipulation of soil is completely reduced to the minimum level. So that's why it is very difficult to cultivate or to have the sowing operations with ordinary equipments. As in minimum tillage, the weeds are controlled mainly by the application of chemicals. So further, continuous use of herbicides causes pollution problems and dominance of perennial problematic weeds. Now, the another modern concept of tillage is zero tillage. The term zero tillage was given by Jethro Tull. Here, the primary tillage is completely avoided and the secondary tillage is restricted to seedbed preparation on the row zone only. The father of zero tillage is J.B. Triplett. He hails from USA. The zero tillage is an extreme form of minimum tillage which keeps 50 to 100% of residue on the soil surface. So here, before sowing of the crop, non-selective herbicides like paraquat, glyphosates are used for weed control. The weeds are controlled only by chemical means. Commonly used herbicides under zero tillage are paraquat and diquat both. Some of the problems of zero tillage are low seed germination, low mineralization and build up of volunteer plants. Here we can see that the seedling germination or the seedling establishment in zero tillage is about 20% less than in conventional methods. Here in zero tillage system, high dose of nitrogen has to be applied as mineralization of organic matter is slow in zero tillage as we have seen in minimum tillage condition. As the primary tillage is completely avoided, here the large populations of perennial weeds appear in zero tilled plots. The next modern concept of tillage is mulch tillage. tillage operation in which nearly 30% of the crop residues or other mulching materials are left on or near the soil surface is called as mulch tillage. Here, the other thing to remember is that the deep tillage or deep summer plowing in the western countries, deep plowing is 50 cm depth for rain-fed conditions, whereas 70 cm depth for irrigated conditions. This was all about the modern concepts of tillage, where we studied about minimum tillage, zero tillage, mulch tillage. Now, after the modern concept of tillage, we will study about the different types of plowing categories, which is prescribed by Central Research Institute for Dryland Agriculture, CREDA, which was established in 1985 and situated in Hyderabad. As they describe the and classified different types of plowing according to their depth. So one side we can see the different types of plowing categories, and on another side we can see the depth in centimeter. So for shallow plowing, the depth is 5 to 6 cm. For medium to deep plowing, the depth is 15 to 20 cm. For deep plowing, it is 25 to 30 cm. So it was all about the tillage topic, which is one of the most important topic from competitive point of view.